Don't you just hate it when you're trying to configure a new audio device on Windows and it takes ages to set up, maybe doesn't even work, and all of that just takes away from the valuable time where you could be enjoying making music? So in this video, we're going to try and look at the common user configuration issues with audio devices. We're also going to speak about the different types of audio drivers that can be found within N-Track, so native ASIO, Wasapi, WDM, MME. We're also going to look at recording live instruments, issues with buffering and latency, and how that can affect quality and performance. Let's get into it. Sometimes we plug an instrument into the computer and experience latency. I'm sure you'll all know the feeling. Latency is when you play a note, for example, on a piano, or you sing into a microphone and you don't hear the note or the note that you've played or sing back until a couple of seconds later. In other words, there's a delay. I've experienced it and I'm sure you all have as well. So let's walk through why there might be high latency and then the solution of how to fix it. Here's me playing the note middle C. So you can hear I'm playing the notes. You can see the notes played via the video camera here, but you can actually hear the notes later, which is quite an annoying sensation. We'll now go into N-Track to see how we can reduce latency on playback. Let's go to the settings menu because the two things to look out for are type of audio driver selected and buffering settings, which we'll go into more detail on later in the video. First, let's look at which audio driver is selected and resulting in this high latency on playback. It's MME. We can also see other types of audio driver above and below MME, which is selected. Let's examine the buffer settings, specifically playback buffering. So we can see that MME has a high buffer size with respect to the number of samples. The lower that numeric value, the less latency, but MME doesn't support a lower buffer size. So the MME driver and its buffering setting is the reason we're hearing the high latency. To illustrate that, we've gone ahead and selected Wasapi as the audio playback device instead of MME. Let's hear if that changes the latency. So we can hear the notes at the same time as their input signal in N-Track. Returning to the buffering settings, we can see that Wasapi is set to fast response. That's because it can handle a lower buffer size, which results in low latency playback. So let's come back to the video camera, hello, and we're going to play the same piano excerpt again, now with the latency settings changed, so all should be well in the world. Hear the difference? That's how that's solved. An audio driver links an audio program to the audio device hardware. Some audio drivers may only work at certain sample rates. We're going to go into N-Track and see how we can change the sample rate. For anyone that doesn't know, the sample rate means the number of samples streamed per second. Back in N-Track, let's go to Settings and Audio Devices to check which audio driver we're using. We've got Wasapi selected and we use that for this example. We want to check that the sample frequency within N-Track matches that of the audio driver. It's important to say that it's optional to check that the sample frequency of the project and your audio driver match, but this is recommended when using Wasapi in non-exclusive mode, meaning that other Windows devices can use the Wasapi audio driver at the same time as N-Track. For example, a Windows system error sound. We know that Wasapi is not in exclusive mode in this example because the exclusive mode checkbox is not checked here. We particularly recommend checking that the sample frequencies match when using Wasapi in non-exclusive mode, because if the project and audio driver sample frequencies don't match as per this example, then Windows, in order to be able to output the audio signal used by N-Track, will have to go through the extra step of converting the audio signal from one sample frequency used by N-Track for recording to another used by Windows for playback. In other words, this creates extra friction, and we can see on screen that N-Track displays a pop-up warning stating that the sampling frequencies don't match, recommending to change them in the Windows control panel. Let's return to check that the sampled frequency within NTRK matches that of the audio driver. So let's go to sound card settings and recording mixer controls to check the sample rate of the audio driver. Let's select our recording input device, go to properties and the advanced tab. We can see that it's set to 44.1 kHz. Let's click OK, go back to settings. We can also check the playback mixer controls. This can also be found quickly in the playback tab next to recording. So let's go to speakers, which is the output device. Select properties and then the advanced tab. Again, it's set to 44.1 kHz. Let's press OK and check the sample frequency inside NTRK by going to settings, preferences, and we can see that it's already matched up to 44.1 kHz, 44,100. This is more advanced, but the Wasapi audio driver only, which we can see is still selected, can be used in exclusive mode, selected here. Only Wasapi can be selected in exclusive mode. So if we tried to select WaveRT, WDM, MME, ASIO, we can see that the exclusive checkbox disappears. Why do we want to use exclusive mode? Well, it provides low latency audio and direct access to the audio driver, bypassing the Windows audio engine, blocking system sounds. When using Wasapi in exclusive mode, it's not necessary to match the NTRK project and sound card sample frequencies. This is because NTRK will automatically choose the sample frequency most suitable to the audio driver when exclusive mode is selected. Okay, moving away from exclusive mode, if the sample frequency in an NTRK project doesn't match that of the sound card, then NTRK will automatically resample audio files that are imported into a project. So the example we're using here is a WAV of a kick drum. You can see we're in Windows Explorer. We've navigated to properties and then audio properties to see that the sample rate of the kick is 48 kilohertz. Let's go back to NTRK and we can see that it's automatically been resampled because the NTRK project is set at 44.1 kilohertz. It's important to note that when a sound gets imported and resampled by NTRK, the pitch of the sound remains the same. Now, let's go through some audio driver examples. Wasapi is Windows's native low latency audio driver. It was introduced in Windows Vista and is the default driver from NTRK 9.0.5 onwards. Let's have a look at how to access it and how it sounds with the example La and with the piano note middle C. So back in NTRK Studio, we'll go to settings and audio devices and ensure that Wasapi is selected as the audio playback device from the options available. It is, so we'll click OK. And we can hear that there's very little latency with that Wasapi audio driver. Let's also revisit how to check that the sampling frequency is correct. So select playback mixer controls from the settings menu. Go into the speakers, into the playback device, select settings, then the advanced tab, and we can see there's 48 kilohertz as the sample frequency for the audio device. Let's check that NTRK has the same sample frequency, and we can see it does. Let's also check Wasapi with an audio example. So we'll go into settings, audio devices, and we can see that Wasapi is already selected with an audio interface. La, so we can hear Wasapi is low latency. La. And generally a good audio driver of choice. Okay, so the next driver is ASIO. ASIO was designed with pro audio in mind. It's typically the best choice over other audio drivers on Windows because of its emphasis on quality. The only thing is you'll need to download the ASIO driver directly from your interface's manufacturer.
So back in NTRK, we'll go to settings, audio devices, and ensure ASIO is selected from audio playback devices. Let's listen to our piano example using ASIO. And we can listen to our audio example. La. La.
You can also use ASIO for All if your interface doesn't have its own ASIO driver. ASIO for All can be downloaded if you Google ASIO for All, and it's a universal ASIO driver. If selecting WDM devices directly from NTRK gives an error, then you can try ASIO for All, which may have better compatibility with WDM drivers that it uses under the hood.
Let's hear an example. So you can hear low latency and you get the benefits of using an ASIO driver.
And that brings us to WDM. WDM stands for Windows Driver Model. It typically has lower latency than other standard Windows driver, but it doesn't always work.
Let's run through an example of that. We'll go to the settings menu in audio devices, and you'll see that we can't see WDM from the list. So we'll need to go to the advanced button and manually check WDM in order to be able to select the audio device. So let's click OK and return to the device's screen. WDM and WaveRT have been added upon selecting WDM from the advanced tab. WaveRT is a minor upgrade on WDM. So let's start with hearing an example with WDM. So we can hear that there is no latency there. And there's another example to make sure. Let's demonstrate an example of WaveRT using an audio track. So we'll bring that up, go to Settings, Audio Devices, and select WaveRT using a Focusrite audio interface. La. La. So we mentioned at the start of this section that WaveRT and WDM don't always work. Let's run through another example of that. We can select WaveRT and we might see an error message like this. It relates to sampling frequency, and we can see that if we press OK, NTrack automatically tries to find an audio format compatible with the device currently selected. Generally, if we press yes, NTrack will recognize the input signal and things will function as they should, but let's run through an example where it might not work. So we'll go ahead and press yes, and we can see that NTrack is not displaying the input signal from the MIDI keyboard here. So let's run through this process again. We'll go back into Settings, Audio Devices, double check that WaveRT is selected. We'll see the same error message, but this time we'll select no for NTrack to automatically find a compatible audio format. To sort this issue, we'll go into Windows Settings, System, then Sound. We're going to change the output device to Realtek Digital Audio and slide the master volume fader. By changing this, we can now hear that WaveRT plays back the input signal as it should. So why does changing the default audio device that Windows uses for system sounds and the default Microsoft software MIDI synth solve this issue? Well, if NTrack tries to access the same audio device that Windows is using, it will fail because it already sees that this is in use. In other words, WDM and WaveRT drivers cannot be shared. Because of this, we had to change the device that we wanted Windows to use in order to be able to free the device that we want to use within NTrack. Let's run through a potential playback issue by going to Settings, Sound Card Settings, Playback Format, and changing the 24-bit mode from standard 4 bytes to 3 bytes packed. We're going to hear that this can create some unwanted sounds. So it's actually quite a cool effect, but obviously not the sound that we want to produce 99.9% of the time.
There's also MME as a driver. It's been around since the 90s. It's pretty much universally supported within Windows, but it should really be used as a last resort as there's incredibly high latency and it's not known for its tune performance. So by using MME, you might find that there's a lot of issues. Let's have a look at an example of using MME so we can see that firsthand within this Microsoft Surface tablet just here.
And before we do jump in, it's important to say that MME has the advantage that it always works. It has 100% compatibility.
So as ever, we'll go into Settings and Audio Devices. We'll see that MME has already been selected. Now, MME is notorious for latency. Let's hear an example of that in action. So there's some delay between us being able to see the input signal in NTrack and hearing the note. Let's hear an example with an audio track and see if there's still that high latency. La. La. We can see there is. MME can be selected in NTrack, but really we'd recommend this only as a last resort because of the aforementioned reasons with that super high latency. In summary, we'd recommend ASIO where possible. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, let us know. Subscribe, we're growing the channel. Leave us a comment if you'd like to see more videos like this, or if you have certain requests. We're putting out more and more content these days, so we're always open to new suggestions. That said, enjoy making music with N-Track. See you on the next one.